Hello everyone, welcome to Wisemonkeys UGC NET Teaching Aptitude series. In this video, I'm going to cover key behaviors and helpful behaviors for effective teaching. Gary Borich discussed the key behaviors and helpful behaviors that makes teachers effective in his book Effective Teaching Methods. So I have taken these points from the same book. And this is very important from NET point of view because this question has been asked previously. So the various key behaviors, let us first move towards the various key behaviors for effective teaching. These are lesson clarity, instructional variety, teacher task orientation, engagement in learning process, student success rate. Lesson clarity, where ideas should be clear to all learners at all levels. Ideas should be conveyed in a clear step-by-step order. They should be uncomplicated and with minimal distractions. Instructional variety, which uses a variety of teaching tools like technology, materials, activities, space, and displays, and use a variation in voice and gestures, rewards, and reinforcers. When questioning, use a variety of questions. Fact questions, process questions, convergent questions, divergent questions, etc. Teacher task orientation. To maximize the time spent teaching, be sure to handle inevitable interruptions quickly, expedite the giving and collecting of materials, prevent or quickly put an end to distracting behavior, organize lessons well, and establish smooth transitions. Be as prepared as possible. Engagement in the learning process means constantly monitor any seat work and group work, set rules for when students can leave class without disruption, keep a daily schedule to minimize confusion of students, give independent work that is interesting. Student success rate, which is very, very important. Students should spend about 60 to 70% of their time on tasks that allow almost complete understanding of the material being taught with only occasional errors. The content should reflect prior learning with easy to grasp steps for the new material. Now let us move towards the helpful behaviors for effective teaching. These are using student ideas and contributions, structuring, questioning, probing, and teacher affect. So using student ideas and contributions, teachers should use mediated dialogues and be sure to acknowledge, modify, apply, compare, and summarize student responses as necessary. Structuring, where teachers should reinforce the learned content and place it in relation to new content. Teachers should give organized lessons of what is to come and summarize what has been taught. Questioning, use a variety of questions and be sure to include questions that require more thinking and problem solving. Probing, draw more out of student responses by getting students to elaborate on their ideas. Help the student to discover the content rather than being explicitly told. Teacher affect. Develop the teacher-learner relationship by the use of enthusiasm, that is, inflection in your voice and movement, gesturing, and eye contact. Here I am ending my video on two helpful behaviors and key behaviors for effective teaching. Thank you for your patience listening and subscribe to our channel so that you keep getting notifications. And if you are having any doubts, please put them into comment section and we will try to solve your doubts soon.